Good morning, everyone. It's Pastor Tim Hammy. It is the 18th of August. I hope you're doing well. It's Friday, and what a great, great day. So we've been talking this week, can you hear me now? A conversation with God from the book of Habakkuk. And we'll continue on. This is a series, Conversations with God. And yesterday we talked about God isn't looking at what I'm looking at. Well, here comes Habakkuk and his whinies. It's as though he's saying God isn't really doing his job. See, when you really think about it, that is a really bold statement. Let's be honest, sometimes it seems like God is on vacation. Habakkuk thought that. I've thought that, and I'm sure that you have thought that also. It's very interesting, Elijah and the Baal prophets. I love the one thing about the Message Bible. It kind of brings it into a very descriptive word. So here's Elijah building a altar, and they're going to see whose God's the best. And here's the Baal prophets dancing around their pile of wood, trying to call down fire from their God and whatnot. And all of a sudden, here is Elijah sitting in the corner making fun of all the Baal prophets. And all of a sudden, Elijah says this to him. I always remember, it sticks out to my mind all the time. He says, maybe your God's on vacation. In fact, in the Message, it says, maybe your God's in the bathroom. And see, sometimes we as followers of Christ, when it's not going or we feel like we're left alone or it's just not doing what we thought it was going to be, well, we think God's on vacation. We think God is not there. And God is. You know, I visit a lot of people. God loves you and I, and sometimes when you're in a situation where you're sick or and you feel like you've been left all alone and God's not healing me at the right moment, the right time that I think, can I tell you this concept? Is God's planning and God's will and God's timing is perfect. And so sometimes you or I may not understand what's going on. Just like Habakkuk, when here we go, Judah's just kind of being messed up, you know, changing their perspective. Can I tell you that the biggest thing I can challenge you with is keeping your eyes on God's perspective? Let me complete this devotional this week. Habakkuk 2:4 says this, the righteous will live by faith. Let me remind you this morning that we don't see the big picture like God does. And there may be times that we just going to have simple trust. When we don't think God is listening, He is. When we don't think that God is seeing what is going on, He is. When we don't think God is working, He is. The old hymn says this, trust and obey, for there is no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Cry out to God this morning. He knows and He cares for the things that you're going through. And at this moment, I'm going to transition. I'm going to pray for you. There's a video that I used to play when I went for a walk and when I lived in Illinois. I still walk. But this song is very important to me because it really opened up that God really cares and that He really does listen. And it's just a cry out, I need you now. And maybe at this moment, as the video is playing, maybe at that moment you stop and you just bow your heads, listen to the words, and let God just speak to you in that moment. Let me pray for you. Lord, I pray for my friends. I pray that You give them a great Friday. And Lord God, bring them to church, wherever they may go. And if they don't have a church, bring them to our church. And Lord God, I thank You so much. Bless my friends, Lord God, as they're a blessing to me in Your name. Amen. God bless you. Have a great rest of the weekend. If you don't have a church, come and visit them on Sunday at 10:30, 9th in Yuba. It's going to be a great time. God bless you.
Words that need a language largest, this longing inside. And I need a voice bigger than mine. And I need a song to sing you that I've yet to find. I need you. I need you. I need you.